Luke, stay up here with me. They moved them all here, and now they're all colorful. It makes this wall. So, you could have came here in the year of 2000 and either gotten your name or your picture. And now there's actually an app. So if you know someone who's on this wall, it's not really a memorial, or it's basically you paid to be on here and have your name permanently engraved in Epcot. So let's go in, because there's the Food and Wine Festival And also the 50th celebration. So let's go in.
Yes, my first.
So yay! Much. That sound is the sound of magic right there. And here we are. Epcot. These are the festival passports this year because Food and Wine and Ratatouille just opened. I won't, unfortunately, won't be able to get on the ride today, but I will be able to get on it tomorrow, so of course tell and show you how it goes. This year's Food and Wine Festival is sponsored by Corksicle. Now it's been sponsored by many different companies in the past, or it hasn't been sponsored, more of presented, and here it is, Spaceship Earth. This is where everyone was talking about the closet lights and tweeting about that this year. And you have to look very closely to see the closet lights. So closely that my camera shakes. So I hope you got to see some of the closet lights on there. But it actually, I saw it last night and it looks super cool. So just trust me, closet lights make a difference. I love that fountain up there, I just love it. Currently exiting Spaceship Earth, and now I'm back in Epcot. Now, due to the deconstruction and reconstruction of Innoventions, I'm not currently, it's very hard to get around. So, I will see you either, I don't know what I'm going to do next. I might, actually, you know what, I might go to Club Pool next. So see you at Club Pool. There's a lot of more walking at Epcot due to the construction of Epcot 3.0. At least it all pays off, because one day there will be Guardians of the Galaxy, there will be a lot more, it'll be a lot easier to navigate. So I'm going to the new Club Pool. Now, there was an old one in Communicore, but now with the reconstruction of Epcot, it has been moved. I've heard mixed things about it. I've heard the entrance looks really cool. And you know what? I'm just gonna wait and see. You know what? So we're just gonna wait and see the new, you know, I heard there's a new soda selection. I've heard Beverly's still there. I've never tried Beverly. So we're gonna have to try Beverly. And you'll see my first reaction to all of it. So stay tuned. If you're looking for the Club Pool, there are signs up to direct you. But it is, so you walk past the Joffreys. It's in between the Joffreys and Guardians of the Galaxy and Test Track. So it's kind of, you have to walk, keep walking past this construction wall. Hopefully in the future it'll be very. In the future, that's what Future World's all about. In the future, you'll be able to walk there a lot easier. But just follow the signs to Creation Shop. And it's right next to Creation. Here's the line for Club Pool. I'm getting in. Here's the entrance, so it looks like the old Coca-Cola bottles from the old glass ones.
Here we are, Club Pool. So I was in line forever, and I'm finally at a station. So I'm gonna go down. Here are the soda options. And I'm gonna try them all. So I'm gonna save Beverly for last. So there's this one called Viva from Moldova. I hope I pronounced that right. And let's try it. Kind of like a extra fizzy Fanta Sprite mixed together. That's what it tastes like. It's really good. Next, I'm gonna try the. It looks like appears to be cucumber Sprite from Russia. Has a cucumber bill picker pickles taste to it, but it just tastes like normal Sprite to me. Next is a smart sour plum flavor soda from China. It looks like Coca-Cola, but it tastes very fruity. Royal Watermelon Fanta from the Philippines. It has that good fruity melon taste to it. Really good. That was good. Joy Apple Lacree from Minute Maid from Korea. Tastes like fancy apple juice. That's what it kind of tastes like. It's like fancy apple juice. It's really good. Next is Country Club from the Dominican Republic. Ooh. Very spicy. It's like a spicy Fanta. Bonbon and Glass from Madagascar. If you could have a plain flavor of soda, that's what it would taste like. Next, now we are going to do it. We are going to try the Beverly. Now, I've never tried the Beverly, and I'm going to try it now. So here I go. So far, it looks just like the last one. I'm kind of nervous. I've heard some things about it. The aftertaste, ugh. Oh, that aftertaste is bad. Ew, it's just bad. Ugh. Let me get something else. That was bad. That Beverly was bad. It tastes like when they do the fluoride treatment at the dentist. That it tastes like fluoride. Toothpaste. It tastes like the worst toothpaste you've ever had. It's just, ugh.
It tastes like
So those were my reactions to Club Cool. Here are the options again. So yeah. Now there was a line, but next time there might, you know, in the future there's probably not going to be a line. Try it out. It's really fun. Now I'm gonna head towards Test Track. If one's not that long, I'm gonna do it. And then on to the World Showcase.
Change some things. See you during the test. And my band C, my final score. I am 2-7. So I'm gonna ride. Once you exited ride. So and there's all the different things you can do now. There's a car that you can like buy, actually, I believe so. And you're skating a band. And you can play a whole game up here. And there's a few other things you can do. And come in here and you can drive your car around up there and drive them there. There's other driving stations and you can design another car. And up here they have the whole showcase. And of course you can buy your photos. And there's a lot of other things you can do as well. If you're not planning on going to very many of the Beacon of Magic shows, which are the projection shows on the icon for the parks, considering at least seeing Epcot, you'll be able to see it from pretty much anywhere in the park. And it's different than all the others. All the others do look good, and they have amazing projections, but Epcot has all of the closet lights that make it look really cool. And then up here, walking to Canada and the Imagination Pavilion, I see Figment. Figment of Epcot. You know, people call him the Figment of Imagination, but I call him the Figment of Epcot. Because you only see him at Epcot. And, oh, that was just the back of him. So if you want to see all the golden statues, I'll have a whole video montage coming out after I find them all. And yeah, here's Figment. So here at Epcot, there's this scavenger hunt, hide and squeak, and hide and squeak, and you put the stickers on wherever he is holding the ingredients. And here he is with some special herbs and tea and spices. So what we do is we'll come over here and we'll get the one where he's holding the spices and you'll get that sticker and then you'll put it on where you found it. So I found it at the refreshment port. So I would put it where it says refreshment port. So that's hide and squeak for you. I'm not going to be spoiling the rest of them, but there it is. And if you cannot find them all and you want to still get the prize, just put the stickers on there and you'll be fine. Up here in Canada, the stores are now open. They were not open last time. And the big totem poles are, you know, they're always here. And so I think we should really go in the store because I haven't been in the Canada store in a long time. So, here we are. And all sorts of merchandise. There's coonskin hats, Canadian soap. There's also a press penny machine with Canada press pennies. And there's nice plush. I haven't been in the store in a while. They have special Mickey Canada plush. And they also have pin trading here. So it's nice and active store. So there's Canada for you. Here at the festival, there is a Joffrey's and a few other food booths are offering some special time options. And inside there is Ratatouille merchandise. So I think I'm going to go in and check out what new merchandise there is for Remy's Ratatouille Adventure. So there was a little sneak peek. I did get some merch in there. And on the necklace, here's just one little cool detail. Hopefully it lights up my face enough. Remy's hanging off one of the cheeses. So, here, back to the World Showcase. Now in the United Kingdom, I'm about to get some fish and chips. Now here's a tip. Use mobile order and you'll get your food quicker. Because you don't have to worry about what you want to eat a million days in advance. It's with quick service. So you just don't have to wait in the long fish and chips line, because there's always a very long line. Here's tonight's fish and chips line. And it goes all the way across the bridge. So if you just use mobile order, you'll be able to pick up your food right there. But I'm glad they are starting to let you not use it, because sometimes you need food right on the dot. To make sure to get your condiments, because you'll most likely forget them when you're getting fish and chips. They have ketchup, and they have mustard, and if you like your fries salted, and I believe they also have malt vinegar. So make sure you get vinegar, because that tastes really good on fish and chips if you haven't tried it. So make sure to get a few packets, and you know, I honestly like my fries with a little mustard, so make sure just get a few packets to go with your fish and chips. So, fish and chips just got out of the oven and pushed off. It was really hard to get a seat. So, here it is. Here's the fish and chips. I'm gonna get my vinegar packet. A little hard to open. There. Make it well vinegar. Now, perfect to eat. And then I also like to put a little bit of vinegar on my fries. Not too vinegary. Those fish and chips were really good. Make sure to try them out whenever you're here at the English Pavilion. And back here there's a gazebo where there used to be Mary Poppins socially distanced meet and greet. I don't think it's there anymore. And then I love the British store. I'm gonna go in real quick and put on my mask. Everyone's chins are breaking out because everyone's putting their masks on and taking them off. They have Paddington. I think that's really cute. I actually like that Paddington. That's really cute. How much is it? $30. It's very soft and cute, but it's also very small. Plus Gorby. That's cute. If you're from the United Kingdom, because I know there's a big Disney community over there, there will be some cool items in here. Look at these pins. Fish and chips. I like that one. This one's cute too. I'm gonna get the fish and chips pin. There's also a pin trading. here.
Ooh, I see the exact same pin. I'm gonna trade for it.
It's a nice pin. This is the new Mary Blair doll. So I'm gonna go get my pin. I'm gonna trade. Thank you.
You're very welcome. Have a
great
day.
Have a magical day.
Thank you.
There it is. The fish and chips pin. Everyone loved it. There's some other merchandise here. Lots of tea. If you want English tea, you can get your fix here. Yeah, that was the British shop. Now the music got all kind of crazy because they're about to do the fireworks show. So, unless I have more time, I'm gonna show you guys the fireworks.
I'm glad they kept the torches from Illumination. The torches were a big part of Illumination. Now they were out of use for Epcot Forever, but they have returned for Harmonious. Glad that they're turning them on and using them. It just burned the grass. So that's why they cannot expand farther back since the new Fantasyland expansion. So, but yeah, Disney knows how to clear up the smoke. Especially, we have some ways to clear it. And, Riviera. I've actually never been to the Riviera Resort before, so I'm going to get on the Skyliner and head over to... I decided before I left I would stop in the World Traveler
I don't see anything particular that I'm going to pick up today, but there is a few things I do want to show you. These coasters from the Food and Wine Festival. They're cool, and those Tervis travel tumblers. They might be made by Corpsicle, I don't know. And I like the Kess penny machines. There's a special 50th one, so I'm gonna get the special 50th one. Actually, no! It's out of order. Dang it. I was gonna get the 50th Figment one. Maybe next time.
We hope you enjoyed your visit to Epcot and World Showcase. Did you learn how to say hello in a different language today?
Fireworks show closing time of the Riviera. So I'm just gonna walk up, maybe chill in the lobby for a second, and then I'm just gonna catch the Uber. So here it is. I've never been to the Riviera Resort before. Most likely everything except for the restaurants and maybe a few shops are most likely closed though. And here it is. Just gonna follow the signs to the lobby. So here we are, the Riviera. Looks like you just go straight forward to the lobby. Now, this is what I was waiting to see. Look, the Peter Pan mural. One side you have Neverland. On the other, you have London. And when you come up here, you have the tower, the Central Tower, and then the lanterns on the other side, and the castle on the other side. A lot of people think, when they think of Tangled and Rapunzel, they usually think of the tower in most of the movie as being the main castle, but actually the tower's more for prison jail cell, so I like that transition. So look at the sign, looks like it's this way to the lobby. Walking at hotels at night is just a little odd because no music playing and just kind of awkward. All you hear is your own footsteps. And there's the gym. Where's, is this the lobby? This might be the lobby. I think that might be the lobby. I don't know. I do not know where I'm going. I'm just gonna go up here. This might be the lobby. I'm just gonna go into the lobby. Someone gave me directions to the lobby, so up these stairs. I like how the lobbies are a little bit higher up at these hotels. Like the Dolphin, the lobbies a little bit higher up. There it is. Can you check the time? And the store is closed, but I'm just gonna window shop a bit. They have Riviera puzzles, poster prints. They have Riviera ornament even. They have some very good Riviera merchandise. They have a lot of Skyliner merchandise. If you're staying here, you will be using the Skyliner a lot. Oh, what I love about the 50th celebration is these hotel doormats. They're just amazing. And yeah, whenever they go on sale at these auctions, because I know they will, they're going to look these at the hotel, so I'm going to have to buy it. So I'm just going to chill out here for a while and make my own work. But until then, make sure if you like this video to give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel for more content. Turn on notifications so you're notified whenever new content does come out. And we'll see you all next time on the Disney Parks Now. Have a magical day.